Hey guys, it's John, and today we are playing Freddy Fazbear's Pizzeria Simulator. This is a game developed by Scott Cawthon, the creator of Five Nights at Freddy's, and it's free on Steam. And apparently, this is it. Okay, we're just gonna make a pepperoni pizza. Go to pizzeria. Throw pizza with shift. Collect pizzas. I see. So we're just tossing the pizza at these kids. They eat three whole pizzas? Not satisfied till they have three whole pizzas, huh? These pizzas are like, they're the size they are. Can we talk about that? Maybe they don't need to eat this much. You're enabling them, Freddy Fazbear. What are you doing? He's trying to take the pizza for himself. Greedy bastard. Yeah, well. Check it out. Huh. Yeah, I'm still getting it in. Well, okay. I'm still getting the pizzas to them, is what I meant. Okay, we're gonna wait. Oh, there's no kids down here, stupid. Do I want to turn on sticky keys? No, I don't want to turn on sticky keys. That it's a dialogue box that pops up whenever you press shift a bunch of times. Windows thinks that I want to turn on sticky keys. All right. We're going to fake him out. That's right. Damn it, I don't want to turn on sticky keys. Okay, this last guy is going to be a little tough. Okay. How many pizzas have you eaten, Shadow Freddy? He's eating a lot. Look, his mouth got bigger. Round four. Hey. Wait, this doesn't look, what? The game's glitching out. I'm getting tons of points though. Hello? What's up? It looks like the one from Sister Location. Okay. Oh.
Begin play. Tape. Leaving dead space. 3, 2, 1. The purpose of this tape is to test automated response times and reactions from vintage interactive attractions following audio stimuli. If you are playing this tape, that means that not only have you been checking outside at the end of every shift, as you were instructed to do, but also that you have found something that meets the criteria of your special obligations under paragraph 4. Follow these instructions, document response times, then safely secure the space before leaving. Upon sealing the room, you are not to return. Begin audio prompt in 3, 2, 1.
That's an ear-piercing prompt.
Document results.
I'm gonna say a hearty no
on that.
Begin
audio prompt in 3,
as in
two,
never again, please.
One.
Can I say no to this too? What am I saying no to? Like,
document
me?
Results.
Like, I don't ever want to hear that sound again.
Begin audio prompt in 3, 2, 1.
I'm gonna go with no.
Document results.
I guess we're seeing if she reacts to it. I feel like making jokes about.
Begin audio prompt in 3.
Me not wanting to hear.
2, 1.
And that's a yes. Okay, we can't document that.
It's
the voice of the Sister Location
it's
girl.
Shine.
Can't remember
it's
her name.
It's time to take your career into your
Brush
own
script.
Hands. You've saved money your whole life. Great. Now it's time to put all your eggs into one basket and take a huge gamble on your future. A gamble that comes with a 100% chance of success in some cases. What are we talking about? We're talking about becoming a Fazbear Entertainment franchisee. That's right, restaurant ownership and management. Something almost anyone can do with a limited degree of success. Sure, it's a lot of money to invest, but everyone's doing it. And that means it's safe and lucrative. With your initial investment, you'll receive everything you need to get started, including a small room, some tables, and electricity. But don't forget about the money you had left over after buying your franchise package. Use it to decorate, buy a stage, buy attractions and animatronics, and much, much more. Now, let's take a look at a few things that will help you get started as a Fazbear Entertainment franchisee, such as atmosphere. Making sure your establishment has an inviting atmosphere is essential to bringing in new customers. Entertainment. Having a lot of entertainment value in your restaurant will ensure that customers come back.
Well, yeah.
Bonus revenue. Coin-operated games and attractions can generate additional revenue during the day, which means more money in your pocket, ready for reinvestment. Health and safety. There may be times when you purchase something of questionable quality.
Why is the owner an animal?
You. Cutting corners is just good business.
Am I missing something?
There are steps you can take to ensure you don't get sued.
But now the owner's a human.
And that brings us to liability. Being a thrifty shopper is smart, but be aware that buying things on sale comes with a certain amount of risk. Aside from the daily risk of lawsuits, there's also the risk that something might be hiding inside whatever you just purchased with that steeply discounted price tag.
Excuse me?
Of course, that would only be a serious danger if there was something outside that's been trying to get in for months now.
We can't prove anything.
Which we are not confirming to be the case. This concludes the amount of help we are legally obligated to provide. Remember, you are now the face of the newly rebranded Freddy Fazbear's Pizza. Wear that smile with pride, and let's make some money. Fazbear Entertainment is not responsible for disappearance, death, or dismemberment.
Of course. Yeah, you covered that in the liability section. A two-step guide to restaurant management. Use catalog mode to purchase items, animatronics, and other supplies. Use blueprint mode to place items, and upgrade your floor plan. Okay. I'm ready, Freddy.
So let's see how much cash you had left over after purchasing your franchise package. Great, that should be more than enough. Now let's get started. On your left are your product catalogs. You can unlock more expensive catalogs by simply purchasing items for your pizzeria. Use the arrows in the bottom right of the item window to browse the products for each catalog. When you're finished shopping, click the button labeled Blueprint Mode to place your items. You can switch back and forth between Catalog Mode and Blueprint Mode as often as you like before opening your doors to the public. When you're ready to open your restaurant for business for the day, click the button labeled Finished in Blueprint Mode. Give it a try and do some shopping.
All right, let's buy the single stage. What I thought was interesting, look at this discount ball pit. Liability risk, 1. Does that mean that there's something in there? I don't like that. Let's get colorful cups and plates. Yeah, let's, what else should we get? Sanitation station, that's $100. Oh, we gotta get the fan, come on. We gotta get the fan. And, let's get, these are crappy animatronics. Pan Stan? Does it even move? Paper Pals. Let's get Mr. Hugs, aka vacuum cleaner. Wait, liability risk 1? Oh. Well, but Bucket Bob doesn't have any liability. Okay, we'll buy him then. Okay, let's go to blueprint mode and set our stuff. So this actually, this is like a pizzeria tycoon type of thing. I mean, obviously that's not all it is, right? Sponsorship offer. Fizz Time Pop Inc. is offering to pay for advertisement in your establishment. Accept. Hey, look, we got $255 now. Upgrade this room to a larger floor plan. Maybe in a second. Okay. Let's put him out there first. We don't want the liability risk one out there just yet. And we got the colorful plates and everything. Let's go back to the catalog. We got like $250 to spend now. Yeah, let's get the balloon barrel. New catalog unlock. Let's get Stan's budget tech. Okay. Let's get the deluxe speakers. Oh, we can't. Enhanced speaker set. And let's get the foil party set. So that's better stuff. Yeah, look at this. This is good. Yes. My pizzeria is coming together. The Faz rating went up. Playtest. What? Wait, what exactly is happening? Yeah, I guess it works. So did I get some money from that? Or no, I didn't. Clean and polish, $50. I don't want to spend all my money. So how do I get more money? I think we're good enough to go live, I think. Let's buy the duck pond. Why not? And we'll put that over here. We've done it. Our Faz rating has gone up, and we're finished.
Your restaurant is now officially open.
Great.
Awesome. That doesn't mean your job is finished, however. You have a lot of work to do while patrons eat their pizza in the other room. From your terminal, you have supplies to buy, papers to print, and repairs to make. Once you've taken care of all the items on your to-do list, you can log off for the day and get out of there.
Can we please talk about the vent?
Supplies and repairs comes out of petty cash, so don't worry about it coming out of your pocket. We've got you covered. The only money you have to worry about is if you choose to upgrade any of the equipment in your office. Now, onto other matters. Something to be aware of is that the ventilation system and your terminal are pretty loud and may prevent you from hearing things in adjoining air vents. That won't be a problem if there is nothing in the vents. However, if you feel that something might be in the vents, you have a few tools at your disposal to protect yourself. You can shut off your terminal and the ventilation system at any time to decrease the amount of attention you're drawing to yourself. Also, shining your light directly into a vent will most likely prevent anything from jumping out. You also have three tools available from the terminal itself. There is a motion detector, an audio decoy, and a secondary ventilation unit. Keep in mind, however, that you can only have one of these active at any given time. Now get to it. Simply log off when you've completed your tasks for the day, and you can go get some coffee.
Okay. Why is this computer in this back warehouse portion with two vents? Can we order vent grates? I think that's first order of business. Order vent grates. Let me see. Activate motion scanning. Surely there's nothing here. This is the first night. So, in case it wasn't clear, this is Five Nights at Freddy's 6. I didn't want to mention anything early on to spoil the surprise, but I mean, come on. Should be obvious by now. So why is it listed I have $5 if I'm not using... if I'm not using my own money? This is weird. It's still scanning. Select a room to activate music. Sure. Okay. Let's activate silent ventilation. It doesn't seem that silent! Just wanna toss that out there. Order pizza kits, please. I don't wanna stay here too long. All right, we're good. This is the last thing I have to do. Man, owning a pizzeria? Pretty easy. Log off.
Great job. It looks like you're getting the hang of this. Now
thanks.
Let's just focus on getting you through your first week. There's a big party here Saturday, and you should view that day as your ultimate test. Make it through Saturday, and you will have proven yourself as the successful entrepreneur that we all know you can be.
Great. Well, I gotta unlock better stuff than Flat Stanley or whatever for the animatronics on stage.
Congratulations on completing your first day. However, your job isn't over just yet. There is another aspect to your end-of-day routine.
What? Yeah, hi!
That is inspecting and salvaging any animatronics found in the alley outside the back door.
Why?
Things are found here quite often. And while we aren't sure why, what we do know is that they can be used for parts, which can mean a much-needed revenue boost before starting your next day. Of course, as with everything else in this line of work, those benefits come with risk. The safest thing to do is to throw it back outside, but then you get no money for the salvage. Choose to keep it, and you run the risk of certain negative consequences, namely death, should the item in question not be as docile as it first appeared. If you do decide to try to salvage it, then you must complete the maintenance checklist. During this testing phase, check on the animatronic frequently. If you feel that it is becoming unstable, use the taser provided to you.
Where?
Can use it 3 times without damaging the hardware. Every use over 3, however, will decrease the item's salvage value. Before you is an animatronic found in the back alley. We are unsure of its origins. It is your job to complete the maintenance checklist before claiming it as salvage. Or, if you choose to, you can throw it back into the alley where you found it and forfeit payment. Please make your choice now.
Let's proceed with the salvage.
You have chosen to proceed with the maintenance checklist.
500 salvage value.
Remember, use your company-issued taser to return the animatronic to a neutral state if you feel that it's becoming unstable or aggressive. You can only use it 3 times before it begins to damage the animatronic and decrease its value.
Begin
moved. Audio prompt in 3, 2, 1.
Doesn't appear to be reacting. Ah!
Begin audio prompt in 3, 2, 1.
He's moving towards me.
Document results. Begin
the
audio
moved.
Prompt in 3, 2, 1.
No, he did. Uh-huh.
Document results.
Fuck! I lost the salvage! If something is loose in your pizzeria, I should have tasered him. I thought if like... New lawsuits, 0. Good. I thought like you were supposed to do it like when he was in motion. Like a trigger finger kind of thing. That's what I thought was happening. Okay, now I know for next time though. Let's buy the deluxe speaker set. No, let's... Ooh. Neon stage lights. Buy these! Let's get... let's get the Midnight Motorist Arcade. Let's go to blueprint mode and set that up. I don't like that it's loose in your pizzeria. I don't like that message. Okay, I'm done now. Finished. Yeah. Let's see what happens. Oh no, we're back here. Oh no. He's loose. Freddy's loose. How'd he get loose exactly? I guess he knocked me out and then he went into the vents or what? No, skip the ad. I didn't realize it was gonna play a pre-roll for me right now. Okay, hang on. So I gotta get through this. Okay. He's over there. Let's work our way through, guys. So if he's gonna come anywhere, he's gonna come from the right. Okay, I get it. Yeah. I mean, I assume. I don't hear anything. Where is he?
Oh, he's right there. He's right there. It showed him. It showed him to the right. I hear him. Did he leave? Okay, he went over there. Okay, I turned the vent back on. Or, the ventilation, whatever. It was getting a little hot. Scanning? What? Why don't you go over there? Huh? Go over there. Where's he gone? I don't think even he knows. All right, whatever. Print some flyers. Don't come over here. I should have scrapped you when I had the chance. Well, I know for next time. I'll make a good salvage next time. Log off. Okay. Jeez, dude. I don't like Freddy being around there. He didn't seem too difficult, though.
Before you is an animatronic found in the back alley. We are unsure of its origins. It is your job to complete the maintenance checklist before claiming it as salvage. Or,
that's
if
spring
you choose
trap.
To, you can throw it back into the alley where you found it and forfeit payment. Please make your choice now.
No, let's do it. Let's do it. Let's proceed with salvage.
You have chosen to proceed with the maintenance checklist.
That's right,
use your company-issued taser return the animatronic to a neutral state if you feel that it's becoming unstable or aggressive. You can only use it 3 times before it begins to damage the animatronic and decrease its value.
Okay.
Begin audio prompt in 3, 2, 1. Document results.
Oh!
Begin audio prompt in 3, 2, 1.
He's like, what the fuck did you just say to me? What'd you just call me?
Document results.
He is not up here to respond.
Begin audio prompt.
I'll taser ya. Okay.
In 3, 2, 1.
I get 3 tasers. I don't think he's reacting.
Document results.
I'm testing to see if they react, right?
Begin audio prompt in 3, 2, 1. Document results.
Hey, is it moved?
Audio prompt in 3, 2, 1.
Audio prompt.
Document results. You have completed the maintenance checklist.
Ooh.
And may proceed with the salvage. Well yeah. Done. End tape.
Let's salvage him. Let's salvage Springtrap.
What a deceptive calling. I knew it was a lie the moment I heard it, obviously. But it is intriguing nonetheless.
Hello? Who is this? It's a prank call. I got salvage revenue. That was most of my total revenue. Most importantly, we don't have Springtrap running around in the vents. Now, do we? That's good. Let's buy the extended stage. Let's put Ned Bear. Liability risk 1. I don't think so. Whoa, marked down. Purchasing a bulky item in this condition comes with a slight risk of something undesirable hiding inside. Let's get Pig Patch. Smiles and ooh, what the heck? Unavailable? What do you mean unavailable? Deluxe concert stage. Ball pit tower. Liability risk 3. I don't think so. Rockstar Freddy. That's a heavy animatronic. That's kind of mean. So I understand. What happens when I playtest? Oh. Wait, this is entertaining? This is supposed to be entertaining? What? What am I doing? Okay. This is the game? I didn't realize. This is what everybody's playing? Cool, I guess. What's my highest score? 2579, did I get on the list? Wait, I got money for that. Did you get money for that? We need to get this guy off the stage. Can I get him off the stage? Okay. Yeah, cool. Finish. So where is everything? Hello? Oh, we're gonna get an ad for that freaking... Oh, shit! Jesus.
But fitting.
I didn't think it was gonna be on my ass that quick.
It is sweet, but fitting. I'm an evil animatronic.
And lots of what? Fun? Fun? Fun. Oh. Fun. Okay. Oh, I like this. This is nice and happy. So as we gotta go back there. Yeah, I wanna continue. I don't wanna start a new game. Yeah, turn on the fan. I don't know. Log off. Bye-bye. I don't know if I should be panicking that much. So hang on. I salvaged Springtrap though. I guess they're like loose in your facility no matter what you do.
Before you is an animatronic found in the back alley. We are unsure of its origins.
What else is there?
It is your job to complete the maintenance checklist before claiming it as salvage.
Oh, come on.
If you choose to, you can throw it back into the alley where you found it and forfeit payment.
We're throwing this one back in the alley. We're throwing this one back in the alley. Salvage value. 2,000. We'll proceed with the salvage.
You have chosen to proceed with the maintenance checklist.
Damn.
Remember,
straight.
Use your company-issued taser to return the animatronic to a neutral state if you feel that it's becoming unstable or aggressive.
Right. No, I get it.
You can only use it 3 times before it begins to damage the animatronic and decrease its value.
That's fine.
Begin audio prompt in 3, 2, 1.
It doesn't appear to be reacting. It's the
document same results.
Same audio prompt. Oh, hi.
Begin
there.
Audio prompt in 3, 2.
You got an ugly
one.
Ass smile, don't you? I'm studying your every move. I don't think anything
document
happens.
Document results.
I'll shock ya! Yeah, that's right.
Begin audio prompt in 3, 2, 1.
You sit back down.
Document results.
No.
Hi. Begin audio prompt in 3, 2, 1.
I'm gonna taser you. I heard that noise you were making. I had to pause it to hear it. What the heck was that noise?
Document results.
Hang on. I did it incorrectly there. I hit yes and no.
Begin audio prompt in 3.
I'm gonna say
two,
yes. She fucking reacted
one.
To that. Oh, man. So when you hear that sound, you gotta shock it. Weird. I wasn't sure what it was. But I mean, hey, this is my first time playing and learning. The good news is I don't have any lawsuits. So that salvage would have really helped, though. I only have $1,200. I don't have enough for the heavy animatronics. Wacky wart paste. Yeah, I'll take the advertisement. Let's get a heavy animatronic. Yeah, let's get him. Let's get Rockstar Freddy up there. Rare finds auction. Confetti tile 4. Wow. Deluxe ball pit liability risk 4. There's something in there. Egg baby. All right. Neon party set. That's $3,100. For paper plates and napkins and hats? Orville the elephant. Security puppet. That's $12,000. Now, why would I get this? $5. Liability risk 9. Look at this guy, the music man, 19,000. El Chip. Funtime Chica, she's been redesigned. Oh, I can buy pickles. They're unavailable though. Can't find pickles anywhere. Okay, let's put Freddy up. He'll add to the atmosphere. All right, I'm a great franchisee, I think. This part still kind of like, it kind of confuses me a little bit. Something here. Whoa! Wow, they-
It feels like my birthday. Did you have a gift for me?
No. It's not your birthday. I'm not getting you anything. I'm sure as hell not getting you anything. Get out of my face. Never liked her. It's my birthday. I just murdered you, but did you want to buy me something? No. Sit your ass down. Wish I could shock you all over again. No! Fuck. What? Heard it.
How could I resist?
What? Shit!
Easier than I thought it would be.
Alright. British Springtrap. Alright, so I've started a new game because I kept dying in that one night because I kept getting those ads running. So I'm not gonna take any sponsorships this time. I feel like I have a better handle on things now. I'm not gonna take any sponsorships, and I'm gonna get those salvages this time to make things easier for myself.
You have completed the maintenance checklist.
All right.
You may proceed with the salvage.
So we got Freddy.
Well done. End tape.
Thank you. So we got Freddy.
Thanks for letting me join the party. I'll try not to disappoint.
You're very welcome, I guess. You're gonna try to kill me tonight, though. Okay, well, yeah, this will help our revenue stream. A lot better than those stupid sponsorships will. What the heck? I got a secret. I'm sure everyone's found this already, but it was cool. I noticed that there was a break in the bottom of the screen, so I went through it. Or if I get extra points. So far, it looks like we're just driving in the rain. Is this the purple man's purple car, or fork in the road? Going south. Okay. Huh. Okay. What are we doing? Is this E.T. for the Atari? There are footsteps going this way. There's some big footsteps right there. That's weird. Okay, let's go up to the house. Leave him alone tonight. He had a rough day. Okay. I told you not to close your door. This is my house. You can't ignore me like that. Open the door. I'll find a way in from outside. Wait, I think I know. What the hell? I know exactly where to go. I found it earlier. It's in the back. There's a window, but it looks like someone's already been there. I don't think your kid's there anymore. Ran out to that place again. He'll be sorry when he gets back. I'll be honest, I don't know much about the lore for FNAF. I'm mostly here for the gameplay and the quirkiness. Alright, I'm gonna do some more grinding. I'll come back. I'm gonna hire a handyman. Hello? I'm also gonna get high-speed uplink. Because I think that those will probably help us overall.
You have completed the maintenance checklist.
All right,
and
so we got spring trap.
Salvage.
Pretty easy.
Well done. End tape.
I mean, I assume I'm doing it correctly.
What a deceptive calling. I knew it was a lie the moment I heard it, obviously. But it is intriguing nonetheless.
Well, let's get one thing straight, Springtrap. No one asked you. No one asked you your opinion on anything. So why don't you sit down and shut up. And I'll tell your friend Babyface or whatever the same thing. Whatever her name is, Baby Dollface, I don't know. All right, so we've got money. Oh, we got money. Okay, got through night three without dying. So that's good. I think I figured out what to do. Seems like if they're close,
before
you gotta turn
you
off
an
the computer
in the
and the
alley.
Fan.
We are unsure of its origins. It is
to
your
really
job
to throw them off
the
and then
checklist before
look down the vent.
As salvage.
So, okay, let's go ahead and salvage this
baby. You have chosen
baby.
To proceed with the maintenance checklist. Remember,
and now I know what to do with that sound.
Taser to re- document results. You have completed
good.
The maintenance checklist.
We
and
got it!
Proceed with the salvage. Well done. End tape.
Cool. So that's 2,000 bucks in our pocket that we didn't
really
have last time.
You don't know who your employer is, do you?
No. And you don't know what's going on in the outside world, so I guess we're even. When's the last time you tuned into the news, huh? Wait, we turned away 47 visitors? What? Alright, whatever. We probably need to ramp this up a bit. We need to ramp up this operation a bit. I think... let's see. Look at this confetti tile floor. We should go for that at some point. Neon party set. Look at that atmosphere. That's a 9. Should we get this? Yeah! Let's do it. Now we got the proper decorations. Check that out. Alright, I'm gonna earn some money. Okay, I've got the biggest possible room now. Look at those balloons. So we've got room for 4 more attractions. Maybe it's time to get rid of the barrel or add a coin slot to it. I'm not sure which one yet. Let's see. Anything else I can get for 700 bucks? I'm gonna get the deluxe speaker set. That's 8 atmosphere that we sorely need. I'll get the Fruity Maze Arcade too. Just getting some quick stuff. Neon stage lights. Novelty traffic light, why not? And we're pretty much all caught up. So I'm not gonna buy anything else from the first two. Now let's start adding this stuff. Duck pond, and sure, that. where? Oh yeah, the novelty traffic light, there it is. And we got the neon stage lights and the, yeah, this is good, I mean, next time I'm gonna upgrade the stage so we can start putting heavy animatronics up there. We'll clean and polish these. Our atmosphere is 31 now. It was 8. But now we've done it. All right, so I didn't see this before. It's Thursday. So we gotta go through the night now. And we got all 3 to worry about. I'm hoping I can do it. I think I've done things right this time. I got all the equipment, which I think buff up things. I heard you. Okay, so I think this is the way to do it. You do a task, you shut everything down, and you listen. And you play the audio every now and then. Yeah. It's like, there they are, right? I heard something. Hello? I think they're gone.
Where are you?
Not here. Did you leave? Last one. Woo! Okay. Yeah, I think I figured it out. That seems to be the pattern. There's always a pattern to these games, and like once you kind of get into the rhythm of things.
Before you is an animatronic found in the back alley. We are unsure of its origins. It is your job to complete the maintenance checklist before claiming it as salvage.
I want this thing!
If you choose to, you can throw it back into the alley where you found it.
This is that
payment.
This is
that make your choice now.
Liability 9 thing. God, oh, 5,000 though. 5,000 though, and we gotta get it. We gotta get it. Cause they send that message, gotta bring them all to one place.
You have chosen to proceed with the maintenance checklist.
Yeah.
Remember, use your company-issued taser to return the animatronic to a neutral
state
if you feel that it's becoming unstable.
Yes, yes. We go over this every time. Come on.
You can only use it 3 times before it begins to damage the animatronic.
What's this thing's name? Lefty or something?
Begin audio prompt in 3, 2, 1. Document results.
He barely moved.
Begin audio prompt in 3, 2, 1. Document results. Begin audio prompt in 3, 2, 1. Document results.
He's not moving. Goes on for forever.
Document results.
Got it.
You have completed the maintenance checklist.
Okay, that wasn't
and
bad.
And proceed with the salvage. Well done. End tape.
They give you way too many shocks there, I think.
Don't forget Saturday. You want them all to be in one place.
Yeah, no, I get it. But, like, so Lefty doesn't talk, I guess. Because Babyface or whatever talked, Springtrap talked, and Freddy talked. After I salvaged them. They all taunted me. But that one didn't. Yeah, okay, that's good. Alright, I get it. I made a lot of money. I made a lot of dough. Good. The good thing is, we turned away 0 people this time. I think they got turned away last time because there wasn't enough room for them, maybe, or something like that. I wonder if I have enough money to get, like, the big stage. Yeah, deluxe concert stage. And then let's just get, I wish we had security doors. Rockstar Freddy, Rockstar Bonnie, Rockstar Chica. We almost have enough to get all 4 of them. But let's see, let's get Foxy. Let's get, Chica, and we don't actually have enough money for all 4 of them, sadly. Well, we can start assembling them a little bit. I don't really know where they're supposed to be honest. We won't have him on there. Let's get Freddy. We gotta have the star of the show. And then if I can make enough money, we'll buy Bonnie. All right, we got enough for Rockstar Bonnie. Let's put them out. We got all 4 of them. Neato. Okay. Well, that was fun. No real point to that, I think. But we have it looking pretty close to the original FNAF. That was my intention, I guess. Aside from all this other stuff, I don't think that the balloon barrel was really there. Who knows? Maybe it was. Is that an extra coin slot? And let's go ahead and check out the next night. I'm ready. Put me in, coach. So this is Friday. Aha! All right, you're probably gone. Wait, there's four. Oh, Lefty's here. Could have sworn I heard something. Ooh. I swear I didn't call you. Fuck. Why would I call you? To come murder me?
You may not recognize me at first, but I assure you, that's still me.
Okay. You guys, you just gotta take your time with this. Hi. What the? What, they're in both? They're in both. Fuck. Heard ya. Stop. Damn. Fuck, stop. That was really close. I know I was covering it up, but the temperature was getting up to like 115. I don't know how high it gets. I don't think it gets very livable indoors at 120. So yeah, that was a close one. First try though. Yeah, I think that's a winning technique. Salvage revenue zero. Oh, I didn't salvage anything. Oh, I didn't even think about it. Yeah, I wasn't salvaging anything. It's Saturday. All right. Cool. Well, we got $3,200. I don't know what really to do with that. I mean, I guess we could buy more stuff, but today's the big party, right? Do we need to make it more presentable? We got a 55 in entertainment. I think that's, like, really good, right? Do we want this gumball swivel hands? Might as well. I don't know what else to get. Not you. That's for damn sure. I don't know why. I don't know why I was so hostile just now. All right, let's go. I'm ready. I hear it. That was really loud. You're really loud. Like, you need to work on that. Okay, I think we're good. Bye. Hello. Okay. Hi. Is that it?
You may not recognize me at first, but I assure you, that's still me.
Do you ever get tired of saying that? You've been saying that every night this week. Why don't you come get me if you think I'm in here? Who are you talking to? Get the advertising out of the way because it's the loudest. It makes so much noise. We good? Still over here, huh? Crap. Hmm? Ooh! Thought you'd just slide on in there, huh? Okay. I heard it, like, twice. Okay. I hear it. Hi. Yes, hello. I heard it. These are the quickest, I think. Hi. We're at 93 degrees. Uh-huh. Uh-huh. Okay, 100 degrees. I heard it. Heard it. Hello. We're getting up to 100 degrees. 98 right now. 100. Okay. Yep. Okay. They love this side right now. They love it. No air. Oh, we did it! We did Saturday first try as well, and Friday. All right, what's next?
You played right into our hands. Did you really think that this job just fell out of the sky for you?
No.
No. This was a gift for us. You gathered them all together in one place, just like he asked you to.
Uh-huh.
All of those little souls in one place. Just for us. A gift. Now we can do what we were created to do.
Entertain children?
I will make you proud, Daddy.
What?
Watch. Listen.
Don't call me that.
And be full.
Connection terminated. I'm sorry to interrupt you, Elizabeth, if you still even remember that name. But I'm afraid you've been misinformed. You are not here to receive a gift, nor have you been called here by the individual you assume, although you have indeed been called. You have all been called here, into a labyrinth of sounds and smells, misdirection and misfortune. A labyrinth with no exit, a maze with no prize. You don't even realize that you are trapped. Your lust for blood has driven you in endless circles, chasing the cries of children in some unseen chamber, always seeming so near, yet somehow out of reach. But you will never find them. None of you will. This is where your story ends. And to you, my brave volunteer, who somehow found this job listing not intended for you. Although there was a way out planned for you, I have a feeling that's not what you want. I have a feeling that you are right where you want to be. I am remaining as well. I am nearby. This place will not be remembered, and
wait,
the memory
what?
Of everything that started this can finally begin to fade away.
Are you
the
setting it on fire?
Every tragedy should. And to you monsters trapped in the corridors, be still, and give up your spirits. They don't belong to you. For most of you, I believe there is peace, and perhaps more, waiting for you after the smoke clears. Although for one of you, the darkest pit of hell has opened to swallow you whole. So don't keep the devil waiting, old friend. My daughter,
Spring
if
trap.
You can hear me, I knew you would return as well. It's in your nature to protect the innocent. I'm sorry that on that day, the day you were shut out and left to die, no one was there to lift you up into their arms the way you lifted others into yours. And then, what became of you? I should have known you wouldn't be content to disappear. Not my daughter. I couldn't save you then, so let me save you now. It's time to rest for you and for those you have carried in your arms. This ends for all of us in communication.
Congratulations on completing your work week. We apologize if your situation wasn't presented to you in a completely honest fashion when you first started, but it was important that your intentions and actions be genuine. Here at Fazbear Entertainment, we value fun, family, and food. But more importantly, we value our commitment to atoning for past mistakes and tying up loose ends. Thank you for your participation. There is no need for you to return to work next week, as Fazbear Entertainment is no longer a corporate entity. Please accept this certificate of completion. Goodbye for now, and thank you for taking this journey with us.
Thanks, I'll take it. Work 1 week, get a certificate, cool, and that's it. Freddy Fazbear's Pizzeria Simulator, aka Five Nights at Freddy's 6, which appears to be Scrap Baby. Is that the name of that thing? Circus Baby. That's its name. So this appears to be like the final game in the entire universe. Because they all got burned up, right? They were all gathered up into that building and burned. Of course, Springtrap in the third installment of the game was burned down in a... I seem to remember that happening as well, and apparently he made it through. He even commented on it in the game. This game is dedicated to the fans. It's been a pleasure making games for you. Aww. I was gonna say that. This seems like a game that was just made for the fans. Hence why it's a free game. Cool. So yeah. All right. I mean, I don't really get into the Freddy lore, but I think I have a rough idea of what happened. It seemed like a very final sequence right there. Anyway, so, okay, let's move on to my thoughts about the game. So, many of you remember when I played Sister Location, I didn't care much for it, the direction that it took. I mean, I didn't think it was bad, but it just wasn't to my taste. I think this was fun. I think it was experimental, and you can just tell that Scott was having fun with this. I mean, there's a Pizzeria Tycoon game during the day cycle of the game, so I think that kind of says a lot about it. Sorry, I'll stop fidgeting with stuff on my desk and talk straight to the camera. So, yeah, I actually liked this. The easiest Five Nights at Freddy's game I think I've played. I struggled a little bit with Thursday until I just calmed down and took my time, because I was trying to, like, you know, flash my flashlight everywhere. I was playing it like it was Five Nights at Freddy's 2. But it seems like if you're patient with it, it's the difficulty actually is minimal. So I don't really have a whole lot of comments on the gameplay of the thing. I do think it's really cool, however, the presentation of everything. That's mostly what I have to comment on. I think that, it was really enjoyable, just the whole thing. Everything from the tycoon aspect of the game, which didn't seem to end up mattering, to the skinning of the game in the Steam store as this kind of throwaway retro style arcadey bullcrap where you're Freddy and you're tossing pizzas at kids. And I mean, if you look at the screenshots for this game on Steam, it's all just that intro couple minutes. And of course, it was released without announcement, and so when people got into it, they were like, you know, what is this? And he's released kind of trolly demos like that before, so it wouldn't have been out of the question to just kind of have it be a little teaser, but this actually ended up being the full game, which I think surprised a lot of people. It didn't surprise me very much. Like I said, I mean, I got it spoiled for me before I played. I mean, I went to the Steam store page and the first review I saw was like, this game is not what it appears to be. And I was like, oh, it's Final Fantasy VI. Just immediately just spoiled right then and there. But that's what I get for looking at the reviews. So it is free to play. I think that Scott did that. I mean, obviously he says that he did that. He made this game for the fans. And I think that it was released for free to kind of shut up all the people whose instinctive knee-jerk reply to any new Five Nights at Freddy's game is another one. He's just milking it at this point. Well, can't really milk something that's free. So I think that that's cool. It's clearly a just for fun end to the series, I would assume. And I mean, it's been over a year and like 2 months since Sister Location, so I think it's been more than enough time for the next release. So I enjoyed it. You know, I think it's kind of interesting that he kept the night cycle portion of the game, where it's kind of this weird hybrid resource management, tower defense, horror, jump scare type of unique blend that he's had since the first game. But in this one, he added a day cycle with a tycoon simulator kind of spin, which was neat. Ultimately kind of empty, as it turned out. I didn't know what bearing it would have on the game. It appears that it didn't really have any. I don't know, maybe you can unlock other endings. I mean, I got the certificate of completion. Let me see something real quick. Do we have like a star on the menu or something? Because usually in the games, there's like 1 star for one ending, 2 stars for completing more, 3 stars for getting all of them. Yeah, there it is. Okay, certificate of completion. So it looks like there's space for 3 more certificates. I don't know. But yeah, this was Freddy Fazbear's Pizzeria Simulator. Interesting, nice surprise for the end of the year. And I think it's just fun. I mean, I know that some people are gonna react to this like, oh my God, another FNAF game. He needs to stop making them. But it's like, I mean, this is his passion. I don't really understand. I mean, I you know, and I'm not even someone who liked Sister Location very much. But I mean, I don't understand that reaction. I mean, I've been making YouTube videos in pretty much the same format for like 5 years now. Should I stop doing it and find something new, you know? I mean, it's the same thing. It's like once you find something that you're passionate about and that you enjoy doing, why not just keep making the same type of thing? And I mean, and on that note, one of the main criticisms of Scott Cawthon is that he tends to make the same game over and over again. But I think that was laid to rest with Sister Location. And if not then, definitely now with this one. This is nothing like the first 4 games of the series. But there's no pleasing some people, I guess. It's kind of just a bandwagon at this point to dogpile on this game. And I know that, trust me, I know that the fan base can be just aneurysm inducing at times. I'm sure I'll experience some of it in the comments of this video, but I think judging the game on just simply its own merits and, you know, with minimal context of the series overall, I enjoyed it. So that's what I got for you. Yeah, that was Freddy Fazbear's Pizzeria Simulator. Let me know what you guys thought in the comments, and I will see you guys later. If you are interested in seeing, you thought I was going to say Think Critically, didn't you? If you're interested in seeing any of my other series on FNAF games, I've got them all linked in the description. I played all of them, all the official ones at least, except for FNAF World. I don't know why I never checked that one out. But yeah, I'll see you guys later. Think critically.